Welcome to the Pet Cuddlatron mini project, where you'll be implementing a fully serverless application using Step Functions, Lambda, API Gateway, and S3 static website hosting. Now, this is the final architecture that you're going to be implementing. Don't worry though, you'll be doing this step by step, and I'll be here at each stage explaining what you're doing and why. In stage one of the mini project, we'll be focusing on just the simple email service or SES configuration, and this is the managed AWS service which lets us send email. When fully enabled, it allows you to send and receive email from within your applications, but to avoid spam, it starts off in a sandbox mode. The sandbox mode means that you have to explicitly verify any addresses that you want to use with the service. For production, you need to move it out of the sandbox mode as soon as possible, but for testing and for mini projects like this, sandbox mode is fine. So in this stage of the mini project, we're going to be adding the email addresses that we'll be using during the rest of the project. Now, I do recommend that you have two different email addresses. It is possible to use a single address for sending and receiving, but I'd recommend using two. The email address that the application will send from and an email address the reminders from the application will be sent to. Now let's go ahead and get those configured, and to do that we need to move to the AWS console. Now to get started, make sure you are logged into an AWS account using an identity with full admin permissions, and make sure you have the Northern Virginia region selected. And once you do have all that set, you need to move across to this simple email service console. So just type SES and then click on simple email service. Now when you first set up an AWS account, the simple email service is functioning in what's known as sandbox mode. And so in order to use it, you need to explicitly whitelist addresses that you want to use, and you need to prove your ownership of those addresses. Now, I'll be using two separate addresses, and I recommend that you do the same. So first, we need to whitelist the address that the emails will be coming from. So when our notification application sends an email reminder, it will use this from address. So to do that, click on Verified Identities on the menu on the left, and then click Create Identity, and then select Email Address. And then you'll need to enter the email address that the emails from the Pet Cuddlatron application will come from. So go ahead and enter that. And I'll be using Adrian plus Cuddlatron at cantrell.io. You can either use this trick using the plus or two different email addresses. In any case, this is the one that I've picked for emails to come from. So Adrian plus Cuddlatron at cantrell.io. So I'll enter that, and you should enter an email address that you control, and then click on Create Identity. Now you're going to be sent an email which contains a link that you need to click on to verify that you control that address. So that should appear in your email box, and you'll need to select it in order for this email address to be able to be used as part of this application. Now, ideally, you'll also have a second email address that will be used to send email to, so the customer who's using this application. So let's go ahead and follow the same process again and enter the second email address, the email address that these email notifications will be delivered to. And I'll be using this email address, Adrian plus Cuddle Customer at cantrell.io. I'm using the Gmail trick again to create another dynamic email address. You should pick an email address that you control. So enter that and then click Create Identity. And again, you'll get another confirmation email that you'll need to click on the link inside that email to verify that address. And once you've verified that one, just refresh and then click Verified Identities on the menu bar on the left. You should see both of them change into a verified status. And that's what you'll need to continue with part two of this demo series. Now at this point, that's all you need to do in stage one of this mini project. You've successfully added either one or two verified identities to the simple email service, which will allow the serverless application which you're going to implement to use these addresses to send email. So we don't need to do anything else in stage one of the mini project, so go ahead, complete this video, and then when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in stage two of this mini project.